I mean, the public school system was started by John Dewey 100 years ago. We survived without it for quite a while.
What was it? During the signing of the Constitution, was the Federalists strongly supported? They were part of Federalism was being having a strong central government.
But Federalists today would be like libertarians.
Okay,
just
but
so
that's
we're clear.
Still that's but still a strong.
They wanted
central
a small
government.
But strong.
But
federal
strong
government.
Central government still sounds like socialism to me.
See, this is very sloppy intellectual thinking. That just because we want a police force, a border patrol, and we want clean streets, all of a sudden we become a socialist.
But those are still social
services. There is a spectrum between small and strong government and like Soviet-style communism.
But we're not talking about that. We're talking about socialism.
Right.
And
so
as
not,
you define socialism,
not every form
of
government
property.
Is socialism. Would you acknowledge that?
No, I don't.
Okay. What's up, YouTube? Hope you guys are feeling good. Today, guys, we're back here with a new video, guys. Having a cold, so permits me sometimes. Socialist does not understand simple economics. Okay, I would love to check this video out with you guys, so let's get right into it.
Yes, sir.
What's up?
Sorry, I assumed your gender.
No, you're good, bro. Yeah. I'm not tripping. So I was disagreeing with you said socialism is non-American, so what do you think is pro-American?
Well, let's define what socialism is, right? Socialism is the government confiscation of private property. It tends to be the rule of the few, not the many, even though they profess to say it's the rule of the many. But the American, let's just say, economic tradition is private property rights, markets with proper restraint, entrepreneurship, the ability to flourish, trade, create new products. Socialism disincentivizes almost all those things. Socialism is built largely on envy and greed. And hilariously, the people that push for socialism, the rank and file, they don't realize that socialism actually just creates an oligarchy. It doesn't actually create a strong middle class, what they allege, you know, to want.
So do you believe in taxes?
Ideally 10% across the board. Yeah.
Okay, so you believe in the confiscation of people's private property?
At some point it depends on if it's private property income or if it's necessary to fund government services.
But that's still a confiscation with a gun through police if you don't
pay. Around 10% to fund public services,
but you just
the military.
Find socialism as taking
private
property.
Well, hold on. The average tax rate in a socialist type environment, and even this country, is what, 55%?
Yeah, but I'm saying taxes in general. That's private property.
So taxation
is
theft. I fully acknowledge a moderate form of something I hate in order to fund a government, police, firefighters, EMT is necessary.
But that's still government confiscating private property, which you said was socialism.
Yes, but you vote for it and you agree with it. I mean, I'm not an anarchist.
Well, why do
I never
agree?
Have been.
I'm an anarchist. I say any form of government existence is socialism.
Fine. Have you ever called the cops?
No, I don't believe. I don't like cops. They don't like me.
Okay, you ever gone to hospital?
No.
Okay, well, one day when you go to a hospital or you use the social service you paid for.
But I'm saying you define socialism as a confiscation of private property, and you're saying that you believe in taxes, which is a confiscation of private wages. Let me go for
the unreasonable confiscation of private property, the elimination of private property altogether. You can have a 10%
tax
rate.
Well, that's not socialism.
Well, they could be conflated. One is a gateway drug to the other. I mean,
okay, but the middle ground.
Lenin said that
socialism
is a precursor to communism.
Okay, but they're still different. If it's a gateway drug,
they're both garden varieties of Marxism. Would you agree?
I agree with that. I'm saying weed is not meth. So let's talk about weed. That's still a confiscation. If you're saying it's a confiscation,
one is better, one is worse,
but if we're talking about socialism, more lethal. You defined it at the beginning as the confiscation of private property.
Yes, correct.
It's also collectivized use. Do you believe in public schools?
Ideally, I think they should be more community-based and more in volunteerism.
Okay, but you believe in them in some level, right?
Well, I mean, again, this is overly abstract and academic. We live in a society where we have government schools, we have public schools, so we could talk about what we want
But if we're talking about what is anti-American, what is pro-American, in the existence of what you say is American, would you say public schools are part of being American?
I mean, the public school system was started by John Dewey 100 years ago. Survived without it for quite a while.
What was it? During the signing of the Constitution, was the Federalists strongly supported? They were part of Federalism was being having a strong central government.
But
I would say it sounds like
Federalists
to
today
me.
Would be like libertarians.
Okay,
just
but
so
that's
clear.
Still
but
that's hmm. still a strong
they wanted a
central
small
government.
But strong s-
but
federal
strong
government.
Central government still sounds like socialism to me.
This is very sloppy intellectual thinking. That just because we want a police force, a border patrol, and we want clean streets, all of a sudden we become a socialist.
But those are still social
services. There is a spectrum between small and strong government and like Soviet-style communism.
But we're not talking about that. We're talking about socialism.
Right.
And
so
as
not,
you define
not,
socialism,
not
it's
every
a
form of government
property.
Is socialism. Would you acknowledge that?
No, I don't.
Okay, then.
But you is, that, but you define
that,
at the beginning
intellectually
of this,
lazy.
No, you define at the beginning no, of this as social. You offered a definition
I've
as
offered offered more nuance to that. I will say it is the unreasonable confiscation of
wealth. Well, how do we define reason? What is unreasonable?
That's up to the polis, the politics to do. I'd say anything above 10%.
Okay, well, how do you define? So
I said 10%. What I get from the Bible. Makes sense. 10% of 10% of what you earn, 10% of what you have goes to either to tithe or to God or to some sort of taxation system.
So just based on the Bible, that's my position.
We can disagree on that.
Okay, so your position is based only at 10%. At 11%, it's not socialism. It is socialism.
No, I'm not saying it's socialism. It gets close. It gets further away from what it is.
Where's the line? What is socialism?
What is the taxation line? How about this? Socialism is you cannot own the property that you desire.
But you're talking about me being intellectually lazy.
This?
I'm saying let's have a stringent definition.
So let me actually give you a real
example.
California is more socialist. Texas is less socialist. That's a spectrum.
But I
want
to know,
you agree
when
with that?
Does socialism begin and when does it end? And I'm saying
you're saying it's not like an entrance into Narnia. If you're saying socialism is anti-American, I'm saying socialism is a part of America.
Okay,
so you want to know when socialism begins and when it ends?
Yeah.
When you leave the free state of Florida and you enter the unfree state of New York.
What's the tax rate in Florida then?
Zero.
No,
the income tax in Florida is zero.
You still have to pay taxes, though.
Federal taxes.
You still have to pay federal taxes.
No corporate income tax, no personal income tax.
But you still have to pay federal taxes. So if you have to pay taxes at all, it sounds like Florida's a socialist state.
So are you trying to say America's currently socialist?
Yes, that's
okay, I would agree. We're going more in that direction. So,
but you were saying socialism is beyond taxes, though. But wait, you just said that America is socialist, but you said Florida is not socialist. So Florida's part of America. That doesn't make sense.
But you pay 20% more taxes here in California than you do in Florida. Yes?
Okay, but they're both socialist.
No, but the federal project right now is more socialist than it is free market. Yes.
Okay, yes.
But in Florida, you get at least some gasp of liberty and freedom that you do not have. In California, if you're a top income earner, you're not paying 15% in addition to a 38% federal income tax rate. That's 53%. That is the government owns a majority of your labor.
Yeah.
So to be even more clear, the closer you get towards the government owning a majority of your labor and your goods, the further and further closer you get to socialism. California is that.
Yeah.
Now, I would love for the federal government to get rid of FICA tax, to get rid of, you know, the excess income tax. I've been clear. I think 10% across the board, fine. We need a military. You might not agree. We need a police force. We need a border patrol. We need basic social services that are a safety net, not a hammock. But I do not believe in this over-the-top type taxation. If you want to talk about other types of taxation that everyone here is paying, it's inflation.
But
when you borrow $2 trillion a year, you do not have, you're getting 10% poorer every single year. I'm going to get to the next question because you keep on saying the same thing over and over again. But
I don't understand how you can say that America, that socialism is anti-American, when even the most pro-American, I think, as you would define, like, would you say Florida's pretty pro-American?
Yeah, I mean, they have no income tax.
But the thing is, if they still have taxation...
No, they have... They're part of the federal government.
If taxation is part of America, and it always has been...
But no, it hasn't.
Always been part of America.
So since you're such a wise guy, how did we fund the government for the income tax?
Through taxation, but I say that's socialist.
Tariffs. We didn't have an income tax till 1917. So I'm going to get to the next person. You should do more studying on American taxation. And there's a spectrum.
I think you should define socialism.
Not every form of government is socialism.
Guys, this video was really, really amazing to watch. I felt like the guy was just aiming to prove Charles Kirk wrong. I'm pronouncing this right now, Charles Kirk, not Charles Kirk. So he's aiming to prove Charles Kirk wrong. Like, that's just his aim right there. It's not to learn more, but to prove Charles Kirk wrong. That was his plan. Because when he said in Florida, they do have federal taxes. Charles Kirk accepted. He was like, oh, that's true. I accept it. Okay, that means Florida is part of the socialist. He accepted. But the guy still he just wants to prove that Charles Kirk is wrong. But Charles Kirk was like, go make your studies right. I know what you're clever, you're a smart guy. But what you're saying about socialist, it shouldn't be how you are describing it to be. Do you get me? Charles Kirk was like, 10% of taxes is enough. That is how Bible pointed it out, that overtaxing is wrong. You get it? So it's reasonable. If you think about it, it's very, very reasonable that when they're overtaxing you, it's really horrible. It breaks you down after your sweat, your hustle, your grind, and they just tax you like 15% or 30 or 25. It's really, really massive. So I kind of like understand Charles Kirk's point of the view when he's trying to tell the socialists how it should work. Charles Kirk is not disputing the fact that socialists exist. You understand? But it's just that it feels like it's it's too much for people to handle. You get also the inflation that's happening. It's way too much for normal civilians to handle. It's really, really high. It's terrible. So I understand the entire video. I love how Chaskek handled it. I love the student, the socialist. I love him. How humble he was. He was kind of like calm. But what I don't take likely was him trying to prove Chaskek wrong by all means necessary. Even if Chaskek have accepted that in Florida, they do pay federal taxes. He was not arguing with the guy. He was just trying to like acknowledge that the guy was right at some point, but the guy still didn't want to accept the facts. He just wants to make sure that Chaskek admits that he's wrong. That was the guy's point of view. He just wants to like prove him wrong. But the guy was actually proving himself wrong because he's not learning. He's just arguing and debating out of the point. So comment down below what you think about this video. Give us a thumbs up. Share this video to as many as you can. Subscribe to the channel. I will see you guys in the next video. Make sure you stay safe. I just bought a bag like an old lady. I'm backwoods smoking. I don't own papers. Pass that 808. That dump shaker. Oh, bitch, you know I'm grinding like a pro skater. Baby, mama bugging. I'm so quick to hit ignore. Buku bitch, in my bed.